intimate wash and creams, lotions and gels and shampoos, and the list is quite big. In personal care, we have some innovative products shampoo bars, which are not soap based actually. Most of the shampoo bars that you will find in market are soap based. So ours is not soap based. And secondly, we have very most innovative product of ours is shampoo butter. So it's a shampoo in a jar with a buttery texture. So that is something that you won't find anywhere in the world. So
Really,
it's quite innovative.
exactly.
And we have this safe laundry range and in-home care. And we have recently launched, it's almost, I think, 8, 9 months back, we launched this dish wash, which is sulfate-free, phosphate-free, and requires very less water to rinse off. So, and this one character is there in all our products, whether it is skincare, home care, or hair care. You require very less water to rinse off. So that is the case even with dish wash.
Yeah,
So
exactly.
all these things are there. And one more character of our products so that we are very proud of is water efficiency. Post use, though, I have said you we require very less water, but we have reduced the use of water during production, or we don't use water as filler in any product. So all our products come in concentrated form, so you require very little, and even a small jar is long lasting. So these are a few of the properties of our products.
Oh,
So
wow.
we follow this philosophy of less is more. So we educate our customers that you have to pay just a little. Like we want the product to last really long, because sustainability being the basic philosophy of a company. That's the main philosophy of the company, and the company was started for the purpose of sustainability. So here we play a bigger role by educating the customers that थोड़ा ही इस्तेमाल करो और उसे ज्यादा चलाओ. We don't want, and one thing that we say our customers, जल्दी मत आना. So we want them to use it judiciously and come back to us once. For example, a face wash, as per my suggestion, it should last 50 grams, should last for almost 2.5, 3 months.
Wow.
So that is something that we are concentrating on, like less is more, and we are working towards that.
Oh wow, it was really amazing. So, Surbhi ma'am, my next question is for you. So,
Yes.
yeah, so can you share your experience about the fun timing, having to test all your products on you? It must have been some time that you have tested your products on you. So, how was it? How was the experience?
I'd say luckily, most of the time it's good. The results come out to be good. Sometimes the results come out with extremely bad hair days. And so those are the product failures, or I would say something that we know that we shouldn't be doing. Yeah, so it's quite fun that way. But when we get to finalize the product that day, for example, when we finalize the shampoo butter, I think until I oiled my hair again, I kept saying, "The shampoo is so nice. The shampoo is so nice." It's quite fun. Keep
Okay.
annoying her that way.
Okay. So, my next question is, how is it being a part of a family business? Can you share about the skill sets and learning you have learned about in there?
So it's always, I would say, it's always fun, at least for me. I've always enjoyed it. And coming from a business background itself, like our generations has been into business, so I think it was very organic, and I've always wanted to be part of it in one way or the other, and I'm glad I am associated now.
Oh wow, really amazing. And education has been a big part of your family, right? So can you tell us can you tell the youth about how you got inspired to do PhD?
It was my grandma. She is a PhD holder. She did it when, in those times when nobody knew what it was. Nobody would dare to do it. And through the kind of, you know, the big family, big joint family she was in, and yet she did it. And I thought if she could do it in such a difficult time, it should be a cakewalk for me. Why shouldn't I not do it?
Exactly. Wow, really inspiring. So, yeah. So, Sunita ma'am, my next question is for you. Business is all about failures and success. So, like, can you share about the failures in this journey like as far so far? Yeah.
Failure, so I have failed many times with each and every product. Because you won't believe, for example, I'll speak about shampoo butter. It was failure of 21 long months. So I was experimenting it for almost 21 months and then I could succeed. And you won't believe it. My experiment would start anytime at 6 o'clock in the morning or maybe 11 o'clock also. If I have something in my mind, I used to trouble my husband and I used to say, nahi, mujhe abhi hi karna hai.
And yeah, that was actually there. She used to ask me to wash my hair at 9 o'clock in the night. I said, I'm not doing that.
So like failure, we have failed with all the products. While developing all the products, say shampoo also, like liquid shampoo, we failed for almost 2.5 years. And the shampoo like we created, it took really a long, long journey. With face wash, with shampoo bar. Shampoo bar was a big failure for us. So like fail, we have failed for while developing each and every product. But at last, like it is the stubborn nature that I have, that I don't want to get depressed with failure. It encourages me to work more, and I have succeeded in developing most of the products the way I want.
Yeah. Wow. So, yeah.
Failure has also been part of our marketing. You know, like initially we failed a lot. We were unable to place the products, and many a times we had to recall the products because those were not selling. Initially, the journey was really very tough for almost 18 months after the launch. And many a times, like, that was total failure. And I think post 18 months, we started getting some success. And from there, the journey started. So that is part of business. And being from a business family, we know, like, we have to, go through that cycle. So, like, that doesn't disappoint us, actually.
I should say that you all are very courageous. Like, you keep on trying and trying. Like, it's amazing, really. Oh, wow. So, ma'am, how can you encourage people to make switch to buy more sustainable products? Like,
See, for me, sustainability is not a choice, actually. You are not supposed to choose it. That has to be part of your life. Because, like, I simply don't understand one simple thing, that we have one planet. We have to take care of that planet. So how do you do that? It is only by your choice that you are able to, talk about sustainability. So, like, I don't know, like, how do I encourage them? I don't know how do I encourage them. They should, if they really want to feel encouraged, they should look at Belandur Lake or the burning lakes of Bangalore, or they can look for the skin problems that even the newborn infants are going through, like the eczema, the psoriasis, the rashes, the allergies, the breathing problems. All this is related to the products, ingredients that are put in the petrochemical ingredients that are put in all the products that we have been using. Most of the companies don't even highlight all the ingredients, so the person doesn't even know what he is allergic to. But if he is allergic to anything, he should know that it is the products that he has been using, and they have to shift it. If they want to get rid of all these problems, they have to shift and make a sustainable choice. And I'll tell you one more thing. People feel that sustainable choice is costlier. but they don't realize that sustainable choice reduces their medical bill. They reduce their illness. I mean, forget about the illness, the chronic problems, skin problems or the breathing problems. And
they improve wellness, overall wellness.
And you have a guilt-free life, actually. For example, I'll tell you, like, the main purpose why we went for menstrual cup was we both had this guilt of disposing sanitary pads. That was our biggest guilt. And we started looking for alternative, and then we found this menstrual cups. And once we started using it, and we said, no, this is such a product and we need to make it make others aware of it. And that was the reason we introduced menstrual cup to market.
Yeah, that's really amazing.
And let me tell you one more thing. Our dustbin is empty because we recycle everything. And that was the reason we felt guilty about these sanitary pads.
Oh, wow.
So... it's
now the dustbin is truly empty, it's just sitting there.
So now it's almost 10 years, it's empty now, and we are very happy about it.
Wow, like there are a lot of things to learn from you all, guys. Yeah, so ma'am, now we'll have one rapid fire round like between you and Surbhi ma'am. So let's start from you. Like, what is your daughter's favorite quality?
She has this quality of helping anyone in the middle of the night also. You call her at 2 o'clock, Surbhi, I have this problem, and she'll reach you. So she has this this quality, and I'm glad that she has it.
Oh my God, so sweet. And Surbhi, the same question for you. Like, what's your mother's favorite quality you adore?
I think it's she'll always find the solution to anything. Like, even if you tell her, no, this is not possible, she's like, no, I'll make it possible.
It's like, it's for all the mothers, like, they all are the
yeah. Yes, absolutely.
Yeah, and okay, the second question is, what's your favorite product from your own product line?
You asking me?
Yeah. I'm asking you.
It's impossible for me to select one, but yes, I can say shampoo butter, because I have struggled a lot for that product. Din raat I say soti nahi thi, because that product had been worrying me a lot. Till I succeed, the day I succeeded, like I was so happy, I could sleep peacefully. So shampoo butter, yes, that's one of my favorite products.
Yeah, your mehnat ka meetha phal.
Yeah.
And Surbhi ma'am, what's about you? Like, what's your favorite product?
Surbhi?
I think there's a network problem. Maybe.
She may have some network problem.
Yeah, she can like catch us later on. So, okay, so let's move on to the next question. Like, ma'am, ma'am is back. Can you unmute, please?
Yeah, I got disconnected, network issues. Yes, where were we?
I was asking you, like, what is your favorite product from your own product line?
I think it's shampoo butter. She said the same thing, right? Yeah. And probably menstrual cup. I think one of these two.
Yeah, menstrual cup is something like we have really worked very hard for that.
It's definitely life-changing.
Okay. So, Sunita ma'am, who is your role model? Like, throughout this journey or throughout your life? Who's been your role model?
It's not who, it's only nature. You won't believe I get inspired only by nature, and I observe nature minutely, and that's the only inspiration. And because of my interest in nature, I have this sustainable love, you can say, like, I want everything to be very sustainable, very simple, and very, you know, like, nothing should pollute the environment. So yes, nature is my inspiration.
Wow, like, really wow. And Surbhi ma'am, what about you?
If we talk about people, actually we can get inspired by many people. Of course, nature is something that definitely inspires you. Your mind is clear. Definitely think better around water bodies. If you talk about business, I would say Ratan Tata or the Tata Enterprises, what they have built, what they do socially, and the kind of social impact that they create is something you can just hope. If we can do even 0.1% of that, then I would think that, okay, we are doing something good.
Wow. And okay, so the next question is, what's your favorite international brand which work for sustainability?
Frankly speaking, I never follow any international brand, nor have I used any. Frankly speaking, I have never ever used anything.
Awesome. Big thumbs up for you. Like, really.
I am pakka Swadeshi. And usme I'll tell you, I am someone who would recommend like this home-based solutions, you know, do-it-yourself solutions. But people are not very happy with do-it-yourself solution. And that was the only reason, one of the reasons why we came up with a brand, so that at least we can come out with safer products. So otherwise, if you ask me, like, main kya istemal karu, I'll give first, my first reaction would be a do-it-yourself solution. So
I'll contact you baad mein, and like, I'll be talk with you. Like, you are so inspiring, and I really want to have a talk with you personally. Like, wow, it's really amazing. And what about you, Surbhi ma'am? Like, any international brand you follow, something like that?
I've been closely following an organization called Ellen MacArthur Foundation, who's working with circular economy a lot. And of course, there's an organization called CV, which is based in Stockholm. They work in water. So these are a few organizations who are researching a lot and doing a lot of good work. There are many organizations in India as well who are doing a lot of good work. There are small organizations which do wonderful work. And I think these small organizations make much bigger difference.
But she's asking about some brand.
Ellen MacArthur Foundation is a brand. It is a brand.
Okay. And so the last question for this evening is, like, ma'am, do you have any favorite phrase to quote? Like, any favorite phrase or your favorite book?
The book that I really, I would suggest everyone is Hot, Flat and Crowded by Thomas L. Friedman. And I also like Rajiv Malhotra's Being Different. These two books are something which is always by my bedside. And whenever I'm free, I read one of the chapters from these books. So these two books are always with me.
Okay, that's great. And what about
you? Must have not heard about these books. You must have not heard about these books.
So,
these are related to sustainability, and being different is related to the culture and tradition. So this is, and I always believe that our Indian culture and tradition have always been very sustainable. We are away from a culture and tradition, and that's the reason, like, we are away from sustainability also. Like, today we need to educate people about sustainability, otherwise it was part of a lifestyle. Like, if I recall my childhood days, like, we used to never throw out anything. There was no waste generation, and it was very different. So it's part of a culture. Like, I'll tell you one simple example. Doodh se dahi, dahi se makhan, makhan se chhach, and chhach se then again. Like, you drink it, you are not throwing out anything. And then this ghee and ghee ka pani also, you're not throwing anything. Absolutely nothing. So even if your ghee burns, I tell them, use it for diya. Don't throw it away. So this is something like I have learned from childhood, my childhood days. Like my mummy was, she never threw anything out. Funnily, I'll tell you, she was one person who used to dry all the peels and make a powder and the body scrub out of it. So all fruit and vegetable peels. So like this has been a lifestyle. Throwing, we never knew what throwing is. So disposing the sanitary pad was a very big problem for us, because throwing was not in my nature. And that was the reason like menstrual cup came up.
It's really a blessing for us, that menstrual cup. It's really. And yeah, yeah. So same about you. Like, oh, what's any favorite phrase or any book?
It's from a song by Jack Johnson. The line is, wisdom is in trees, not glass windows. It always, you think about it and it's always been my favorite line.
Oh wow. And any book you would like to recommend us?
I think the more you read, I always liked one book called Rich Dad Poor Dad.
It's
a very wonderful book.
I agree with you.
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah, these were all the questions, and it was amazing having you all today. And Ankita ma'am, would you like to join?
Yes, I'm just gonna ask a quick question before I go offline. Could you just give us two lines on how do you integrate sustainability in your life every day? Like, you know, you all don't have a dustbin. You all are amazing and so motivating. So just like five takeaways for our users. Where do we start to integrate sustainability in our house? Just five takeaways. Let's start now. It's never too late, and today is the day.
Yeah.
Five ways to start, and how do we do it in the house? Thank you.
See, the first thing that I would say is, whenever you purchase anything, whether it is your personal care, makeup, clothes, or anything, think 101 times that whether you need it or not. तीसरे बार में ही जवाब मिल जाता है चाहिए कि नहीं. And if you really don't need it, simply never purchase it. So reduce your purchases. That is one thing that I would say. And that one philosophy is, we have put in our products also कि कम आओ हमारे पास. You come rarely to us. You know, like if you purchase once, you come back after maybe 3 months. So this is the philosophy. So secondly, you have to segregate and you have to recycle everything, because that is very important. Thirdly, don't use the as you are all young and tomorrow you all will be mothers, and you have to take care of a generation to come. So like, do never use these disposable diapers and disposable sanitary napkins or tampons. All this is polluting the environment like anything. And one more thing that I follow very strictly, since ages I have been following this, I never get poly bags for anything. You know, we have these cloth pouches made, and I carry those cloth pouch to Kirana store. I never pick up anything from a D-Mart or you know, like More or something of that sort. From malls or super shoppies, where everything is pre-packed. I always go to the Bajuwala Kirana store, and I purchase in my own cloth bags. So you reduce tons of plastic over there, tons of plastic that enter your house. So you have to take care that all these things, like the plastic, the poly bags, those don't enter your house. One thing that
reuse of stuff.
Yeah, reuse. Like if something enters your house, keep reusing it as much as possible. One thing that we also follow at home is, we don't go for this packed food, you know, like whether it is sweets or savories or anything, like that is minimal in our house, minimal. So everything is made at home, like snacks and everything, we do it at home. And hence we reduce the, entry of these bags and unwanted garbage in our house. That is the thing. And we recycle even the smallest bit of paper that maybe it's a small bill or anything. So that is also recycled. So these are few things that can be done very easily and everyone should do it actually. So.
Thank you, ma'am. That was amazing. I think very quick takeaways. Do you want to add anything, Surbhi? Just like simple things, what you do, because it's so difficult.
I'll just add one thing, is saving water. Saving water is very important. We use it frugally to use it as sustainably as possible.
Yes, I think saving all resources, what you're
saying. All resources, yeah.
Yes, it's exactly. Very important. And that's what the mission of Sustain and Save is, to create more awareness about sustainability, about circular economy. It's very difficult to do this switch, but I think once we get inspired, I think action is possible. And only, so there is an inspiration, and people like you, like such amazing, inspiring stories can always inspire the youth and make us bring about the change. So I think it was really, really nice. I have a lot of takeaways for you, and we'll definitely edit it, give us, you know, have takeaways for the video today. Thank you, ma'am. Do you want to conclude, Nikita?
Ma'am, you can actually.
Okay, so we had thank you so much. It was really inspiring, and we would love to know more again whenever we can. We would love to also use your products, and thank you so much for giving us your time and this opportunity to take your interview. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.